Old John was a king in his own native land. He ruled for 1,000 days till the slave traders came and they locked him in irons, and they told him that he'd have to go away. They told him that he'd have to go away. Old John got sick on the long ocean voyage. All around him people died. They took his friends and they threw them overboard. John hung down his head and he cried. John hung down his head and he cried. They sold Old John down in New Orleans to a man with a whip in his hand. He said farewell to his wife and his child, and they took him to a strange new land. And they took him to a strange new land. Old John worked hard for 37 years. He worked with a woman by his side. And on the morn that his last son was born, Old John laid down and he died. Old John laid down and he died. His son grew up just as big as his dad, and they called him Old John too. And for 100 years, Old John and his sons did just what the master made them do. They did just what the master made them do. Until one day when the cannon fire roared, and the master's wife and children did flee. Some men in blue coats rode into the yard, and they told Old John that he was free. And they told Old John he was free. When the night riders came for old Old John, little Old John hid behind a tree. He saw what they did and he hit the northern trail, saying, maybe up there they'll let me be. Saying, maybe up there they'll let me be. But they pushed Old John and they shoved him around till he didn't know where to turn. Some folks up in Harlem took him into their home, and Old John started in to learn. And Old John started in to learn. He fought for his country in World War I. His son fought in World War II. And they learned no matter what price they paid, there were certain things they weren't allowed to do. There were certain things they weren't allowed to do. And then one night on the television screen, he saw that Medgar Evers was dead. He took his wife in his arms in the night, and these are the words that he said, Old John. These are the words that he said. Well, they made me a slave and I worked in their fields. They made me fight in their war. They kept me down for 400 years, but I ain't gonna take it anymore. No, I ain't gonna take it anymore. His wife got a letter from a Georgia jail, from a town called Albany, saying, I am proud to be your own, Old John, and I ain't coming home till we are free. No, I ain't coming home till we are free.